In this lesson, we will look at one of the ways to create a navigation menu in Autoplay Menu Designer. Let's look at it in one of our templates. Let's create a navigation menu on the base of one of our templates. We will use features of the subwindow object and internal variables of an object. First, we will create buttons of our menu. For the buttons, we use the rectangle, ellipse, and the graphic button object to create the icon. On the Over and Pressed tabs, we change the properties of button elements to add interactivity for the button. The last step is to combine all elements of the button so that they will work as one. The rest of the buttons are created in the same way. We just copy them from the gallery. So, our navigation menu is ready. But for now, it does nothing. Now add the subwindow object to the main page to specify the area where contents will be placed. Add three new pages with a content to the subwindow object. Then link our buttons with these pages using the Open Page action by the mouse click event. Test our project. The navigation works, but we don't see the active menu item. Let's add a new button that displays the active state of the profile button. We will control its visibility using internal variables of objects. This method requires certain skills, and it may be easier for many people to use the Show Hide Objects action to control visibility. So, select the new button, go to Under the Variables section of the Properties panel, and select the Visible variable. Next, link it with the Cur Page Number variable of the subwindow object. The value of the variable curPageNumber retrieves the index of the currently active page in a subwindow object. So our expression indicates that the button is visible when the active page index is 0. Test our project. Sometimes it's better to use the curPageName variable, retrieves the name of the current active page of the subwindow object. Test our project? The work is done.